I've heard teenagers complain about having to turn in or turn off their cell phones in school. They complain about a lot of other rules too. I think it's mainly because they don't understand or think about why the rule is there to begin with. When a teen complains about a rule, I sometimes respond by telling them that every rule exists because someone has done something foolish. We learn as we go through life that rules are generally in place to protect us. They protect us from being harmed by others. They protect others from being harmed by us. And rules exist to protect us from ourselves. There are times when we feel a rule is too restrictive and we dislike it. And likewise, there are also times when even though we disliked it, we are glad that the rule was in place. Either way, we know that citizens that violate established rules are liable to stand before a judge who can either punish or show mercy. And all people, whether they know it or not, will stand before God who will judge each of us at the end of time. How will he judge? Moses said of God in Deuteronomy 32:4, his work is perfect, for all his ways are justice. And then Jesus said in Luke 6:36, that God is merciful. Now many will ask, how can God bring about perfect justice and still be merciful? The answer is Jesus. Because of the sacrifice of his son, God can be both just and merciful. And we've often read or heard John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son. God loves us and wants the best for us, just as a loving parent wants the best for their children. And just like a loving parent, God gives us rules to protect us and offers mercy for the times we disobey. Several times in the book of Psalms, God is praised because of the value of his rules. For example, Psalm 119 verse 164 says, seven times a day I will praise you for your righteous rules. And then several verses later in verse 171, the psalmist writes, my lips will pour forth praise, for you teach me your statutes. Then he writes this, let my soul live and praise you, and let your rules help me. Did you catch that? The psalmist praises God that his soul may live and that God's rules help him. And God's rules help us. His rules are for our good. Don't you want to know and follow God's rules since they're there to help us? They're there to help us live. Each and every week we gather to worship at the Eastern Meadows Church of Christ. As we worship, we learn of God and what our response should be to his love and mercy. And I hope to see you there the next time we do.